was a battle in the north, and nobles there were many, and they have killed Sir Charlie, and laid the blame on Geordie. Oh, she has written a long letter and sent it to his lady. You must come up to Edinburgh town to see what news of Geordie. When first she read the letter, or she was both red and rosy. She had not read a word but twa when she turned pale as a lily. Go fetch to me my good grey steed, my men will all come with me, for I will neither eat nor drink till Edinburgh town to see me. And first she saw the head in black, and then the axe to end him, and Geordie coming down the stairs with bands of iron upon him. Though he was chained and fettered strong in iron and steel so heavy, oh, not the one amongst them all was so fine a man as Geordie. She's down on her bended knees, I'm sure she's pale and weary. Oh, pardon, pardon, noble king, and give me back my Geordie. Tell the heading man, make haste, our king replied full loudly. Oh, noble king, take all that's mine, but you yak, my dearie. The Gordons came, the Gordons ran, and they were stark and steady. And not a word amongst them all, but Gordon's ever ready. An aged lord at the king's right hand said, noble king, but hear me. Let her count out 5,000 pounds and give her back her dearie. Some gave her marks, some gave her pounds, some gave her dollars many. She's counted out 5,000 pounds and got again her dearie. She's glancing private in Geordie's face, says, dear, I bought thee, Geordie, for the blood would have flown upon the green before I lost my laddie. Small and kissed her lips so rosy. The favorite flower of womankind is my sweet bonnie lady.